Hey, this is Swedish Guitar Nerd, and today I'm gonna do a review of a pedal. It's actually a multi-effect pedal, and you know I like those. It's the K818 from Greenchild Amplification. You may or may not have heard of this company. It's a small family-based company in the US. Mason Green is basically, if I understand it right, the guy that's running the place, and he's an engineer. So he's designing these and building these, and the company is named after one of his children, actually. This is the K818, as I said, and it's a dual multi-channel, multi-effect pedal. It has two built-in overdrives, and it has well, it's very nice and shiny and red, and it has a griffin as a sort of a logo, and that's very suitable because that's like a mixture between a lion and an eagle. And yeah, these are supposed to be two classic, or now classic at least, overdrive circuits that are completely independent, and yeah, so you can basically use them apart and stacked. So the way it works is this side, the channel one, is supposed to be mimicking a Klon pedal, a very famous and now very expensive overdrive pedal. And this side, the channel 2, is supposed to mimic a Tube Screamer from Ibanez. And the signal goes like this. You go in here, you go into the Klon circuit, you go from the Klon circuit into the Tube Screamer circuit, and then out. So, yeah, that's how it's constructed. Yeah. And they basically have the regular controls you'd find on an overdrive pedal. So it's like gain or drive, just to set them apart, I suppose. Treble and tone. So gain and drive is, yeah, the input gain of the pedal. Tone and treble, both are very much affecting treble and upper mid range. You'll hear it when I try them out. And output and level is, yeah, it's the volume of the pedal. It's an overdrive pedal, and most reviews I've seen of these are by Blue Skies, and I'm not a Blue Sky, if you can tell from my hair. I play rock and heavy metal, so this will be from my perspective. Maybe a fresh one. See how I can use it. An overdrive pedal is normally used, of course you can use it any way you want it, but the idea behind an overdrive pedal is to have already driven or slightly driven amp, and then use the overdrive to just push it up a little bit more. And yeah, so that's what I will do. I will show you with a completely clean amp as well, just to see, but it doesn't really, I don't know, it doesn't really do the thing it's supposed to with a clean amp. So yeah, you need a bit of hair on your amp to get the right tones out of it, I think. That's my opinion. So yeah, now I'm gonna do some demos. I'm gonna start with the Klon part of it. And yeah, we'll see how it works out. Okay, so here's a completely clean amp. And then I add the Klon part of the pedal. And here's the Tube Screamer part of it. Yeah, that was basically just to give you an idea what it, the pedal in itself sounds like, but that's not how it's supposed to be used, in my opinion. So here's a more driven amp, and now we'll get I'll get to really review the pedal and show what it does. So here's the amp without the pedal engaged. As you can hear, the controls are very responsive. You get a lot, even though it's just I'm only using two controls because the levels. So yeah, you can get a lot of sounds just from this one channel of this, or one pedal, what do you call it? Okay, now I've engaged the tube screamer channel. Thank you. Now set all the controls at straight up 12 o'clock, and I'm just going to compare the channels if you can hear a clear difference in sound. So here's the red channel. It's a green channel. It's not really dramatic to me, at least. Maybe you hear a bigger difference than I do. So let's start stacking them. That's the whole point of this. And a great thing about this that you can have two pedals in one is that, at least with this design and construction, you don't get as much noise if you had, as if you had stacked two pedals separately. So, what should we start with? I'll start with the red channel, and then I'm stacking the green one on top of that. So, yeah, first here's the red channel on itself. Infrared sustain. Again, something you'd like to have when you're stacking overdrive pedals. So, yeah, that's basically what you're after, I think. More drive and more sustain. Okay, just the green on its own, so you can hear the difference when I add the red channel. Then it'll be like the red channel boosting the input of the green channel. So here's the green channel on its own. And with the red channel boosting the green channel. sustains all right. Okay, finally what I'm gonna do is try to find a basic sound for me and then find the perfect added... Okay, finally what I'm gonna do... Finally, I'm gonna try to find a good rhythm sound for me and then add the next channel to boost that for a lead. And I think I'm gonna use the green. I don't think it's supposed to be used like this, but you can use it whatever way you want. I'm gonna use the green channel as my main tone and the red one for boosting that one. So yeah, just hear me fiddle with the controls here. Let's try to find a lead sound. This has been my review of the Greenchild amplification K818 pedal. I found it kind of fun. It's really nice to have two separate channels and to be able to, yeah, cascade them as you do here. You just put one into the other and yeah, I find it really useful. These are fairly expensive. And you can understand why, since it's a family company and they are made in small quantities. So that's what you're paying for. And yeah, of course it costs more. What do I miss in this pedal? I think what I would use this for, maybe, sometimes, is to have both channels on at the same time and then turn both on at the same time, and you have to have big feet to do that. So I don't know, some kind of bypass switch, or at least like an output for a bypass switch would be handy. And also the idea of cascading the channels. If there would be like a dip switch somewhere where you can choose which channel comes first, because they are separate, as I understand it, separate circuits. So, and I'm no engineer, I don't know what I'm talking about, but maybe it's kind of simple to make like a small dip switch inside of it and just to choose which one comes first. Because that probably affects the tone of it a whole lot. But all in all, I think it's a great pedal. I can really see the use of it. And as I said, I did my review from a hard rock metal approach. And it really suits that as well. It really, yeah. It screams, it really does. So yeah, I hope you found this interesting. This has been the Swedish Guitar Nerd reviewing the Greenchild K818 dual overdrive pedal. See you soon. Bye.